Welcome everyone. Today we are going to see about a software called Zotero. This is a reference management tool. The reference management and reference writing is a time consuming process. There are different and variety of styles. So to make this easy, we can use a reference management tool. So first we are going to see about how to install the Zotero. So go to your Chrome browser and go to zotero.org. Zotero is a free and open source software. This is available for Windows, Mac and Linux. So click on this download button and you will be presented with two options. One is the Zotero for Windows, next is the Zotero connector. Zotero is available for Windows, Mac and Linux. If you are using Mac OS, then you can download the Mac OS version. If you are using Linux, then you can download Linux version. So I am going to download the Windows version. I have already downloaded, so I am going to cancel this. Next, I am going to install the Chrome connector. This Chrome connector is useful to connect the Zotero and the Chrome browser. If you are browsing your articles in PubMed or ScienceDirect, you can download the articles from the PubMed or ScienceDirect to the Zotero. So this is the Zotero connector. This connects the Chrome and the Zotero tool. I am going to install the Chrome connector. Then it will take you to the Chrome Web Store and click on this add to Chrome and add extension. It will download the extension and it will install in shortly. Now the extension is added successfully. So next is the very important step. Click on this extension icon and pin this Zotero connector to the address bar. If you pin this Zotero connector, it will appear on the address bar. So this is very handy. So that's all. The Zotero connector is installed successfully. The Zotero installation is very straightforward. Just double click on this downloaded software and press next and install. The Zotero will be installed. That's all. Next we are going to see how to add citations to the Word. Next I am going to open the Microsoft Word. Go to the Zotero tab. If you are installing the Zotero for first time, this tab will not be present. So you have to connect the Zotero to the Microsoft Word. So now we are going to see how to connect the Zotero and Microsoft Word. Open the Zotero. I have added already few articles. We will see how to add the articles later. First we are going to see how to connect the Zotero and Microsoft Word. So go to Edit and click on Preferences. And there are many tabs available. Go to this Site tab. And below this Site tab, there will be two tabs, Styles and Word Processors. Go to Word Processors and click here, Install Microsoft Word Add-in. I have installed already, that's why it is showing Reinstall. Okay, if you are using LibreOffice, you can install the LibreOffice add-in also. Actually, you can integrate the Sci-Hub to the Zotero and you can download many articles inside the Zotero also. This will be very handy. Then click OK. Then Zotero tab will be visible now. To add a citation, click anywhere in the text and go here, add or edit citation, and type in the article name or author name or title or publication, anything. It will show the suggestions and click on this and click enter. Then the citations will be added. Like this we can add many number of citations. Okay, title or year or the publication name, it will show the suggestions. So this article is already cited, that's why it is showing under the cited menu. So in my library there are many articles, these are not yet cited. I am going to choose this and it will add the citations. I am going to add another one also in the same way. I am going to add this article. So like this we can add any number of citations. It will sequentially number the citations. Okay, even if you add 1, 2, 3, if I am going to add a citation here, it will renumber the citation order also. See, I'm going to add a citation here, then it will renumber this citation 3 to 4. So I'm going to add this. So I'm going to add a citation here. I'm going to add this article. See, now this became 3 and already we have numbered this one as 3, so that became 4 now. So like this it will renumber automatically depending on the citations order. So next I am going to add another one citations here. I'm going to add this comma et al. So now, until now, I have added 5 citations to this. So I want to add bibliography to this article. So to add the bibliography, you have to type the, you have to place your cursor anywhere and click here, add or edit bibliography. Then it will add the bibliography here consequently. According to the order which is present in the text, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it is added 5 references to here, okay. So this is very useful and very fast. Then we can add another citations also now. When we add the 6th citation, it will update the bibliography and it will include 6th reference also. So I'm going to add the 6th citation. This is the 6th citation. This is the 6th citation. After adding the 6th citation, then it will be updated in the references also automatically. So let's scroll down. So the 6th reference is also added. Okay, like this, it will update the references automatically when you add the citations. Now we are going to see how to add articles into the Zotero library. So this is the Zotero library. We have to add our articles to the Zotero library before adding the citations into the Microsoft Word. So this is the My Library. We can add many folders and subfolders. This is the Zotero library. We can add folders and subfolders. You can click right. You can right click on this My Library and you can add a new collection that is called new folder. Then you can click on any folder and click new subcollection to create any subfolders like this. Folder 1 and subfolder 1. Like this you can create any number of folders. So I'm going to add some articles to this Zotero library. So to do this, I'm going to PubMed. So this is the PubMed. I'm going to take this article as an example. So click on this article. When the article is opened, you can click on this icon, Zotero icon, and it will start saving this article to your folders. If you want to change the folder, you can click this arrow mark and you can change the folders and you can click on done, and this article will be added to your Zotero library. These articles are fourth year medical students. Let's see. See this and see the article is now added to the Zotero library. So if you want to add another article, you can repeat the steps. So just go to the article web page and click on this icon and it will add to the corresponding folder. If you want to change this folder, just click on the another folder, then click done. Then it will be added to this collection too. Like this, we can add many articles into the corresponding folders. Suppose if you have your article in the PDF format, we can add that also. These are the articles downloaded in the PDF format. So to add these articles, so just select the articles that you want to add. Just drag these articles and drop into your corresponding folder. And this will add the articles into your Zotero library and it will retrieve the associated data from the internet. It will add the author name, year, title and every details to these articles. See, this article has shown error, so this data is not available. So I'm going to click close. See, now the articles are added into the Zotero library. Like this, we can add the articles from the PDF or from the web page. Then we can use this in our citations and references. This tool is very convenient for writing references in the articles, thesis and dissertations. So if you added an article multiple times, it will be presented as a duplicates. So if you have any duplicate items, it will be shown in this option called duplicate items. See, these are the duplicates I have. So if you want to merge the duplicates, click on the article and click here, merge two items. Then these two items will be merged and it will be presented as a single article. So like this we can merge the duplicates. And if you delete any articles, it will go to the trash. We can see the trash here. If you want to export all these articles, then right click on this My Library and click on this Export Library. And it will ask for the format. You can click any format. Okay, these are the various formats available: CSV, bookmarks, BibTeX, and LaTeX. So there are so many formats to export these citations and export this complete library. And if you want to export the PDF files also, click on this Export Files. Then all associated PDF files will be exported also. So if you choose the folder and give the file name, and that's all, the library is exported. See, this is the exported library. If we open this library, there will be a file called mylibrary.rdf. This file contains the citations and references, and the folder files, this contains the PDF files. This contains the PDF file of the corresponding item. You can install an add-on called ScienceHub. Using the ScienceHub, you can retrieve the PDF of the article easily. If you want PDF for an article, right click on it and click on this find available PDF, and it will search internet and it will give you the PDF. But this article is not free, so it is showing no PDF found. Video, please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.